Hello everyone, today we are going to solve this question, minimum index character. So we have two strings, str and pad string. What we have to do is, as you can see, we have three characters in pad string, s, e and t. Okay, we have to find the character of pad string which is present at the minimum index in str string. Okay. So, as you can see, S is there in str string, which is present at 4th index, right? E is also there in the str string, which is present at 1st index. We have to find the minimum index, so we will see the first occurrence of the character, right? As you can see, there are other E's as well, but as we want the minimum index character, we will take the first one. So we have S present at 4th position, E present at 1st position, and we do not have T in Geeks for Geeks, right? So there is no significance of T in this question. So we have 4 and 1. We have to find the minimum index character. So our answer will be E, which is present at the 1st index. Okay. This is what we have to do in this question. Let's iterate it one more time. We will be given with two strings, str and pad string. We will have some characters in pad string. We have to find the minimum index character of pad string in str string. That means the character which is present at the minimum index in str string will be our answer. Okay. So let's see how we can approach this question. Now let's see the first approach to solve this question. So the first approach is brute force approach. What we will do is, we will find each character in the str string, right? Each character of pad string in the str string one by one, and then we will see which character is present at the minimum index. Okay, first of all, let's start with S. We will start finding from the starting. We will reach the first occurrence of S, which is at position 4, right? What we will do is, we will take a minimum index variable, and whenever we find a character at some position in str string, we will update this minimum index, right? First of all, we will see S, which is present at 4th position. So we will put 4 here, and also we will take another character variable, which is answer, let's say, and we will put S into it. Okay. Now I will see if E is present in this or not. Yes, E is present in str string. We will start from starting, we will iterate it. We will see E is present at the first index. We will compare 4 with 1. Okay. As we can see, 1 is less than 4. So minimum index will be updated to 1. And our answer character is also updated to E. Okay. Now we will see if T is present in str string or not. We will start from starting. We will go till the end. We will not find any T. So nothing will happen here. And we have got our answer, which is E, and which is present at index 1. Okay, we have to just return E here. So in this approach, what we are doing is, we are iterating this str string again and again for each character of pad string, right? So what will be a time complexity? It will be, for each character of pad string, which is the size of pad string into size of str string of str. Okay, this will be a time complexity. Let's say the size of str string is n and the size of pad string is m. So our answer will be big O of m into n. Okay, but this is not a good time complexity. So we will move forward and we will see the better approach. The space complexity of this is big O of 1, because we are not using any extra space. Now let's move to the better approach. Now let's see another approach to solve this question. In this question, we will decrease our time complexity by using some extra space. So in this approach, what we will do is we will use an hash map. Okay. So how it will help us? We will store first occurrence of each character of str string in this hash map. Okay. And then we will find for each character in patch string that if that character is present in hash map or not, and which character of patch string is present at the minimum index. Okay. So in hash map, we will have each character along with its index. Let's start from G. We will have G with index 0. Then we will have E with index 1. Then we will again have E, but we will see in the hash map that E is already present or not. Yes, E is already present. So we will not update its index because we want only first occurrence, as we are finding the minimum index. Then we will go to next character, which is K. This is a new character. So we will put it in the hash map and we will get it with the index. Now we will move to next character, which is S, at fourth position. Now I will have F. After S, we will have F. F is at the fifth position. Now again a new character O. We will put it on the sixth. Now R. R will be put with 7. Now we will have the repeated characters. As you can see, G is already present. We will not do anything. E is already present. E is already present. K is already present. S is already present. So we will not do anything in the hash map. We will not update anything. Now let's see how we can find the minimum index character of patch string. We will start from the character S. We will see if S is present in this hash map or not. Yes, S is present. On which position? Fourth. So same thing, we will take a minimum index variable, okay, and an answer variable. Answer variable will contain our character and minimum index will contain our index. So as we have found S in the hash map at position 4, so we will have 4 here and S in the answer. Okay, as we know that finding any character or getting any character from hash map is a big O of one operation. Okay, so this will take big O of one time. Now I will go to E. As a character, I'll find if E is present or not. Yes, E is present on first position. So as we have got the minimum index or an index smaller than the minimum index variable, we will update it. Instead of 4, we will have 1 here. And also, as we have got the character at first position, we will update E in the answer. Okay. Now I will see if T is present in hash map or not. T is not present, so we will not do anything. And we have got our answer, which is E. We will just return it. So as we know, we have used a hash map. It contains the characters of str string. So if the size of str string is M and the size of patch string is N, the space complexity that we are using is big O of M. It is the maximum time space complexity that we are using, because if all the characters are different in str string, then the space complexity of this hash map will be big O of M. This is the worst space complexity. Okay. Now let's see the time complexity. As we know, finding any character from hash map is a big O of one operation. As we are finding n characters in this hash map, so we will have big O of n into big O of one time complexity, as we are finding n characters of patch string from this hash map in which each operation is taking big O of 1 time. So this will be our time complexity. So it is equivalent to big O of n. So our time complexity is big O of n and our space complexity is big O of m. This is better than the previous approach. So this is our final answer. Thank you.